Rank and file are a bit lively this afternoon. Chief Inspector's got them straining at the lead.
Hear about a new probation on CT this morning. Got called to a burglary at a newsagent's and he cuffed the shopkeeper before he knew he was the victim.
Legend George are running a book for the fastest response times for the week.
We won't be if I can catch him.
Keeps them on their toes. Is this supposed to be funny?
Yeah, hilarious, Sarge.
He deserved it, didn't you, young boy Bert?
Now, all I said, Sarge, was that B team's times were faster than
theirs. All right, Reg, come on, get yourself together.
Yeah, get them off, Reg.
All right. This is not a rugby club. Got a job of work to do for the next 8 hours. Do you think you can manage that?
Sarge.
Right, well, get yourselves ready for parade then.
I think the team needs a bit more bromide and a lot less of the hype, sir. The incident with the probationer this morning more or less sums up the problem, in my view.
What do the sergeants feel about it?
You'd have to ask them, but as a supervising officer...
I hear what you're saying, Andrew, but we're talking about professional officers, most of whom are very experienced. I don't think we need to look for problems.
We just wait for them to happen.
If you're still concerned, we can talk about this again at morning prayers, tomorrow. All right.
Sir...
Debbie and George on the school run, refs at 5. Reg, you can go with Tony in the RT. And Dave and June, I want you in Panda 8-4, both of you, refs at 5. Nick, ride shotgun with Steve in the IRV, refs at 6. Sir?
Right. We'll be continuing with Mr. Stritcher's response exercise today as before. He's on his way down to let you know about further developments, but first I want you all to listen very carefully when I say that I don't want anybody getting carried away out there today. We're looking to improve our call response times. We are not going to go out there and act like cowboys.
Ready for me, Andrew?
Yes, sir. Afternoon, everyone.
Right. Overall, you're all responding very well so far to our exercise. Well done. But I'm still looking for more from you. So we're going to assign some new priorities for first response today, linking up with suspected racial attacks that CID are investigating. Study the info sheets and keep them with you. These are random but violent attacks. So getting there quickly could make the difference between life and death.
Can we get on with it, Rich?
Yeah, Tony, yeah. Oh, ladies, you know the men are definitely getting there faster, don't you?
In your dreams, Rich.
What, you want to bet on it?
Yeah, well, you can stick me down for a fiver.
All right, you're up.
Sucker.
You're taking a bait, Jim.
Hey, well, it might just shut him up.
Oh, yeah. Take your time. Mr. Stritcher's lurking. So watch your P's and Q's.
How's that going to help, Sarge?
Oh, my typing's up to it. Sounds like he wants us to write a book on every call.
Business as usual, mate. I'll flag some names and addresses passed on by CID. Apart from that, we do it as normal, OK?
OK.
Thanks. You've been nice. Mind your back with that other one, though.
Okay, then.
Bye.
Thank you.
Who's the fan?
A lady with a grievance.
Against Steve?
Oh, not officially. He brought a couple of D&Ds in. Yes, he'd been fighting outside of a pub. Miss Turner's one of the girlfriends. She claims that Steve pushed her when he made the arrest.
Did he?
Well, he says not. She seems happy enough with the apology. They're flying around the ground, trying to shave seconds off. No wonder they're wound up by the time they get there.
It's not an excuse, Bob. But I don't like it any more than you do. I've got to put in a quick appearance at the Jasmine Allen residence meeting. How's Matthew?
Well, he's like the rest of us. I mean, these sit reps and timings that Mr. Stritch wants. And then if anything happens, there's so much PR talk going on. An officer could be in trouble, anything.
It's only 2 more days.
But are you going to say anything to Mr. Stritch? I mean, make a point.
I'll think about it.
Yeah. 8-4 from Moscow location, please.
West End of Dishman Street, Sarge.
We've got 3 miles fitting CID suspect's description in vicinity of the Askill Road Youth Club.
Stick it in the fourth and floor at Fittipaldi.
Your info, the youth club flagged as a possible target for an attack.
Might be lunch.
Have you got the most shots Mr. Stritch gave out?
Affirmative, Sarge. Show us dealing.
Backhouse Street, Alcott Road, yeah?
No. Road's closed. Do a right here.
That way? Yeah?
Yep. Left at the bottom. Bumps, June.
What?
Mind the bumps! Oh, good effort, June. First decent call we've had on these tow rigs in weeks.
Yeah, all right. Sarah Oscar from 643.
Go ahead, June.
Can somebody else take Askill Road? We've had a Pollack. Damage only.
Oscar from Oscar 21.
Is it knackered?
Nah.
Oscar from Sierra 1.
Probably just written off.
All received. What happened, June?
If there's a complication or a pursuit, remind them to stay in close contact with us. I want to log as much detail as possible.
Sir.
Sierra Oscar 2-1,
location please. Yeah, well, how long do you think they're
going to be? Top of Askill Road now, Oscar, no sign of anyone.
Yeah, all right, I'll hold.
Don't forget your timings on your message updates, Cathy.
Sir?
Oscar from Sierra 1, we've just passed the youth club, no suspect in sight.
Received, Reg.
Oscar must have moved on, sir.
Any news from the AA?
Yeah, right, okay, mate. Be about an hour, better let them know.
Shut.
Sorry, Chris, I thought we were onto something, but we had a technical hitch.
Next time.
Sir? Call on the main set.
Who's assigned?
Nick and Steve, sir.
All units from Sierra Oscar, Malkin Square, assault, 3 suspects.
Show us dealing, Rich.
Hold on.
Stop the stopwatch, Rich.
Oscar from 408. We're in Malkin Square now. We've got 1 victim on the ground and 3 suspects on their toes.
Evidence gone away.
408 from 218. We'll stay with the victim. You go with the suspects. Go on!
Did you receive that, Oscar?
Yeah, received. Back up some way.
Right, let's have him.
Oscar from Oscar 21. Chasing suspects down Brim Street towards the canal.
Received, Nick. 561, location.
We're with the victim now. Male, IC4. He looks really bad.
Suspects now in Jamaica Lane, Oscar.
Evening.
One from Oscar, location,
Rick. 40 Road, Sarge. We'll be there in 2 minutes.
Go
left! Oscar 2-1 from Oscar. Situation report.
I'm in the derelict factory off Jamaica Lane, following one IC3. Steve's with the other two.
Steve. 363, keep us in the picture, Steve.
Come on, I can do this, pig! Phil! Oi, pig!
Three, six, three from Sierra Oscar, location.
Come on, man! Come on, you trash! Do your made up, come on!
What did you do?
Not so bad for a pig.
You're breaking up, Oscar. I'm not receiving you. I've lost my one, but I think I found Steve. We're at the derelict factory offices, bottom of Jamaica Lane.
What is your problem?
You're not going to give up now, just as we're starting to have some fun, are you?
Come here then, you mad bastard.
You come and get me. Come on, you come and get me.
He's about 20-ish.
What about the other one?
No sign of him.
There!
Suspect sighted, Sarge.
Steve?
Steve, you all right? Where's the suspects?
Well, one of them took the shortcut.
Life pronounced extinct at 1620.
Thank you, thank you. He's dead, sir.
You can arrest him too, then? The murderer?
Shut up!
I saw him do it! Hear that, boss? I'm accusing your boy of murder. I was there. Push my mate out of that window!
Shut up, Rich!
You'll have to do more than that to keep this quiet! You scumbag!
Steve, do you want me to get you a cup of tea or something, yeah?
Yeah, that'd be nice, yeah. Cheers. Steve? I didn't push him, Sarge.
No, we know that.
How?
Well, because you told me and Mr. Munro that that wasn't the way it happened, and we believe you.
He's not going to believe me, though, is he?
Bob. We treat it as a murder scene as of now. Davis is going back with CID. Mr. Stritch wants Steve and Nick taken back straight away, and anyone else present to follow as soon as we sort it. He's already called CIP.
And has anyone mentioned the response exercise?
Chief Inspector's calling it off to give the troops a breather.
Well, talk about closing the door after the horses.
Not exactly what we needed, even as a clear-cut case of accidental death.
And that's Mr. Stritch's opinion, is it?
I don't think so. FME's got a lot of opinions as well. Marks on the body, inconsistent with a fall, indicate a violent struggle immediately before death.
But Steve hasn't denied there was a tussle.
He's not completed it, then.
There's the CIB. Make yourself comfortable. You want a cup of tea or anything?
I'm not thirsty, thanks, Sarge.
Look, keep your pecker up. There's no way this is going to go the distance.
It's in here, sir.
I want to know what you're doing about
what I saw.
You'll be interviewed about that.
Yeah? When?
Next year. Oh, what now, then?
Is this the heavy mob?
Sir? I'm Superintendent Halliwell, this is Sergeant Steen. We're here to ask you about the death of Philip Walker.
Well, well.
What's happening now then, sir?
CIB are in with Davis, you're next.
Then what?
You'll want to know what happened from your point of view. So, what are you going to tell him?
Sir?
Just what I said.
Well, it was hard to make out. Everything was echoing. I heard Steve's voice once, so I knew he was up there. When I got to the top, everything was quiet. I walked along the corridor and into the room, and Steve was by the door looking down.
Then what?
He said one of them took the shortcut.
That's not going to be helpful.
Well, look, I won't say that, obviously. I mean, it was just he was...
Andron, I'd like Steve's clothes removed in case Mr. Halliwell wants them for forensic. Could you sort it out?
Is that really necessary, sir? He's admitted they had a fight. His stuff will be covered.
I'm trying to anticipate anything that would slow down CIB's investigation. I think speed's best for everybody concerned, don't you?
I think I'd cut Steve just a little slack where possible, sir.
Like you did yesterday over the incident with the pub fight. Miss Turner?
Well, that's not relevant, isn't it?
I've got a few calls to make, then I suggest we discuss this further in my office, Andrew.
As soon as you're ready, sir.
Two officers saw you leave the square.
Not us. It's a fit-up, isn't it? Cover-up for what happened.
Why run, then?
Run first, ask questions later. Same as what most people do when they see a pig.
I don't think that is what most people do.
You think what you like.
Right, then. We think you're a violent racist who's attacked a lot of defenceless people in this area.
Nah, you're way off. I ain't got nothing against Pakis, so long as we're in Pakistan ripping off other Pakis.
You mentioned Pakistanis.
It was in the papers, weren't it?
No.
Get me a lawyer. This is a fit-up. I want a lawyer. Now!
Cant reports you asked for, sir.
Thanks, Matthew. Come in.
Matt, sir. I don't want to waste your time, sir.
Say what you've got to say, Andrew.
Well, first of all, I'd like to request that in future, if you want to find something out about an officer on my team, you ask me first.
Sometimes I may need to research more broadly than just asking you your opinion. Carry on.
Well, secondly, I'd like to know why you're so interested in undermining Steve Loxton's position before the IO even talks to him. I'd also like to know why you find it so hard to believe Steve Loxton's innocent of a crime alleged by a violent racist with a criminal record. And finally, I'd like to know why you've been prepared to ignore my opinions completely in favour of some apparently instinctive belief of yours that Steve's a problem.
You should have told me about the complaint against Loxton from yesterday.
It wasn't an official complaint.
Does that make a difference? As his supervising officer, you should perhaps have been aware...
Are you suggesting that this occurred because of some negligence on my part, sir?
No, Andrew.
Because I think the question of broad responsibility is very much still open.
I'll come back to that. From my observation, Steve Loxton appears to have a recurrent problem with self-control.
I disagree, sir. You pass Steve Loxton in the corridor a couple of times, scan his record for 2 minutes, and you think that qualifies you to have any opinion on his qualities as an officer?
My rank qualifies me for that, Inspector.
But not your experience.
All right, Andrew. I'll concede impressions can be misleading. He comes across to me as insubordinate, ill-tempered.
He's a straight-ahead, decent officer. Sometimes he lacks tact.
I can't afford to let loyalty override dispassion. So can you do the same? Can you, in all professional conscience, say you're convinced he's innocent?
Yes, sir, I can. And I think we should be using all available time to help him prove it.
All right. We'll keep this conversation to ourselves for now. And I'll see what we can do to get behind Steve Loxton.
Thank you, sir.
Yes? Okay. Thank you. Superintendent Halliwell would like to see you in your office.
Have a seat, sir.
Right, Inspector Munro. I'd like some background from you. About your lad and the events leading up to the incident.
Fire away.
Your chief inspector's been running a response time exercise. What do you think about that?
I think there's always room for improvement. The Commissioner's charter set a standard. We need to meet it.
Some senior officers believe that this sort of exercise can put undue pressure onto officers on the ground, affect their reactions. Perhaps make them more likely to behave aggressively. What do you think?
I'd agree to some extent. It depends on the officer.
Was Steve Loxton the sort to feel it under that sort of pressure?
No. Well, I mean, no more than the whole team was. The officers here have a very hard job to do, and we've got more large estates in Sunhill than most have across a whole area. That's one reason why our response times are sometimes slower on paper.
I see.
Well, the officers were all very aware of the need to make progress on the racial attacks. There was quite a lot of pressure, and we'd had some technical problems.
Mr. Stritch doesn't agree with that analysis. He seems to think that the experience of the officers on your team was more than sufficient to handle the situation.
Well, experience only goes so far. There's a point at which stress gets harder to manage, however professional you are.
Enough to push PC Loxton into the action Davis says he took?
No, sir. Well, I'm not saying... I was talking generally, not about Steve Loxton.
But you're saying they were being pushed too hard. Now, you could be interpreted as offering me a mitigating circumstance.
No, sir.
Any news, Sarge?
Davis is sticking to his story. You've been interviewed yet?
Yeah. Whole thing's a bad joke.
Yeah, well, it's all about the chief inspector marking out his new territory, isn't it?
Polly, Dave, when you're finished, can you come with me?
Yeah, sure.
We're due back out, sir.
I've okayed it with Mr. Munro. Rich, I understand you're the possessor of a stopwatch.
Yes, sir, that's right. Tom Burke got it here.
I wondered if I could borrow it for an hour.
Oh, sure, yeah. Be an honour.
I've been going through the CAD reports from this afternoon. By checking through the timed message updates, I've worked out that 47 seconds elapsed between Walker's body hitting the pavement and the time Davis appeared at the bottom of the building.
So?
So that's very fast. I want to try it out.
He stepped back, he stumbled on something, he put his arm out to steady himself, and bang, he was gone.
All right. Now I know the basics. I want you to take me through it again in as much detail as possible, from the time the fight started. PC Loxton, Mr. Davis has made a highly serious allegation. Now, if you want to leave it like that and let me make my own decision about it, that's up to you.
No, sir.
Have you told the IO about this, sir?
He was still in with Steve. Let's see if it helps first. Are we clear to go in?
Yes, sir. Sokka's been and gone.
This way, sir. Chase them up here.
Pretty grim.
This is it, sir. It's the window over there.
Okay. We don't know exactly which route Davis took, but we have to assume he didn't know his way around the building any better than we do. So let's start blind and see where it takes us.
Right, there's obviously an exit there, sir. I'm ready.
We know where we want to end up. You two take off on my signal. I'll follow with the stopwatch, and we'll see what happens. Okay, Polly, Dave.
Right.
Three, two, one, go! Either Davis is a bionic man or he's lying through his teeth. We got it down to 87 seconds. And that was knowing the route. I don't think any ordinary mortal could have done it faster.
Very impressive, sir.
Any luck?
Yes, sir, I think we've got a result. Davis' solicitor has informed him of the seriousness of the fabrication. He called his whole story into question.
He's dropped the complaint and he's ready to cooperate. Your response exercise served one useful purpose anyway.
Thank you very much for your help, sir.
What happens now, sir?
I'll stick the paperwork through. He'll have to wait for a formal decision.
Can I pass an opinion on the outcome on to PC Loxton?
I think you can recommend he stays optimistic.
How are you feeling?
Nothing 4 pints wouldn't obliterate.
Hey, hey!
Well done, Stevie.
Steve, right. I'm on my way. I just wanted to let you know I'm glad it all got sorted out.
Oh, thank you, sir. And thanks for what you did.
Forget it.
Well done, Steve. I'm delighted.
Cheers, Tosh.
Well done. Oh, sir.
I'm sorry, sir.
Thank you.
Who organised this, then? Maybe he's not such a prat after all. Cheers.